Come on, baby, let's go. I'm Johnny Caswell, I'm 77 years old, and I have a lump on my back. You wanna see the big one? It looks nice and big. Feels soft, squishy. If my mind was in other places, I might get turned on, who knows? As it grew, I procrastinated about it. I had no insurance, I had no doctor, I just kind of let it go, you know, and let it get big, and I paid no attention to it. It does feel like there's a solid mass, but it's not attached to anything. It doesn't seem like it's just floating around under my skin. As it grew, it became a part of me, and I developed habits to deal with it. Hi, how you doing, baby?
Nice to see you.
Whenever I hug someone, I would always go in from the right side. Hi, how are you? Some people would ignore it, but other people would say, Johnny boy, what's that thing? And I would say, well, that's my boob. That's my nippleless boob.
I can feel it right here.
Well, of course you can.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why I don't do that.
That's one of the worst parts of having something like this. And I am concerned at my age, can this hinder my existence or infect my health in any negative way? I have all those questions that would linger in anybody's mind about a condition that they're experiencing physically. I know that I've been sort of throwing a lot of levity in this and trying to be funny and all that stuff. And I know that you're not feeling like that about the actual procedure that we're going to be involved in.
Are you nervous about it or anything? Or are you like...
No. I'm feeling excited about it now.
My dad's such a comical guy. He's super funny and he's very lighthearted. So he made it, you know, seem like it was always a joke and it was always funny to him, like, oh, it's the boob. But he told me one day, he's like, it's kind of embarrassing. Once I started to see his nervousness, it made me realize, wow, this might be like a thing that makes him a little self-conscious.
I love you.
Love you, Dad.
The more I dive into the deep end of this pool, the more I realize I'm doing a lot of it for me, because if this thing could be gone, that's a good thing.
You want to see what Dr. Lee took off?
Yeah.
Look.
It's crazy. Is that a huge skin tag?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Where was it? It was on the back of his leg.
Here, you guys want to touch it?
Yes.
You do? Okay, here. You can see, because I think it'll still be a little warm.
Oh,
yes. Yes, it will.
Oh my gosh.
I know, that's tough to have on the back of your knee for a while. He was really nervous, and that's why people wait. You know, that's exactly why
they worry about
so long.
What it could possibly be.
Or just like freaked out about getting it done.
Yeah.
Well, I'm finally here. I'm finally here at Dr. Lee's office, and we're gonna go for this lump. See this thing? Can you see it? How do if I get like this, can you see it? How about if I do it like that, can you see it? But anyway, I've had it for a long, long time, probably 25 years. And I really wanna know what the diagnosis is.
Okay, so right in here.
Thank you.
Have a seat. Dr. Lee will be in shortly, okay?
Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Appreciate it. As I get older, my well-being becomes a primary concern, which it wasn't when I was younger. But these days, you know, you get very concerned about your physical well-being, and I am concerned. Hopefully, it'll be gone before I go home.
Johnny Caswell.
That would be me.
Hi.
That would be me. Hi.
How are you? It's very nice to meet you. Welcome. Nice to have you here.
Nice.
What are you doing here? You're looking too good.
Shall I show you the reason?
I suppose so.
Bada boom.
Bada boom. Is that what you call it? I like it.
Bada boom.
Bada boom. Okay,
bada
my hand's a little cold. I'm sorry.
That's bada boom.
Bada boob. It's bada boob instead. Yeah, what do you think you got here?
You know, I don't know, and I'm anxious for the diagnosis. I'm anxious to hear what you have to say about it.
All right. You know that this is a fatty tumor, or what's called a lipoma. I'm concerned about it because it's so big, and we don't love something growing like this at this size, but sometimes they're hard because I have to wrestle with them. On the back, I don't always love them because I gotta wrestle with them. And so I'm just hoping that this is not a fight on our hands, because I plan on winning.
Johnny is actually somebody who looks younger than he actually is. And so I think that Johnny kind of can fool you in terms of how
healthy he is. With Johnny, as with everybody, I just need to make sure that he's very safe, that he is comfortable, that he's not in any distress, because somebody who's older might handle stress in a way that may be more concerning.
Let's take off that little bada boob. Yes, that's right, okay?
Yeah. So bada boob, I'm gonna go bye-bye. And I'm looking forward to recouping and being rid of it.
So let me just put some numbing right here. We got my numb in here.
I'm nervous. I'm anxious.
You okay?
I'm okay.
Okay, good.
Yep.
You may be a little sore tonight, but I don't think it's anything that even a little Tylenol can help with. Not going below that muscle, if we don't have a fight, you know. If we have a fight, it could be something different. He's like in its own little capsule. Bada boob. Okay, I'm gonna push against you, okay? About this little bad boy here. Johnny's pop was really quite beautiful, just like he is. But the bottom of it was a little bit tethered. It's a little stuck to his muscle.
I'm just working on that last little bit that's kind of wanting to stay with you, so.
Ooh.
Okay.
Ooh. Hello.
So for me to pull it a little bit, it elicits a little discomfort from him.
So you're doing okay?
Well, just push it on right you. There, a little pain.
Oh,
right
I'm
there.
Sorry, a little pinch? Is it stingy?
The whole sore. Area is now starting to ache.
Okay. We've almost got him all the way out. Almost got him out. I think it's just pulling on your muscle underneath, but it's just because it's kind of stuck to you a little bit. You okay?
Well, it's hurting a little bit.
Because I'm pulling on you, but I almost have him.
I disengage a tethered lipoma very carefully. You'll see me mainly use my fingers. I'm trying not to use any sharp objects because I want to probe down deeper in any area that I shouldn't be. And certainly I don't want to disturb his muscles or any deeper structures. I think we got him. I think we got him. One last thing to do, just to stitch Johnny up and send him home bada boobless. Okay, you want to see bada boob? This is bada boob.
Holy mackerel. Man alive. That is crazy.
That's a good looking boob though.
Okay.
Good looking boob. Whatever you say. I've seen a lot of boobs. I've seen a lot of these kinds of boobs, like lipoma boobs. That's a good looking one.
Look at that thing.
He's pretty heavy. You want to hold, you want to put a glove on you because you can hold it. There's a weight to it.
When Dr. Lee showed me bada boob, that big chunk of fatty tissue, it was quite a fascinating experience for me. Look at that thing. I can't wait to get my hands on it. God, that is amazing. My daughter's got to see this.
Oh, yeah.
You're something, man. You're really something.
Oh, so are you.
Really something. I feel really good about the future. I feel better about the future than I did when I came in here today. I don't have this growth.
We'll send a part of it in just to make sure it's nothing to worry about.
Okay.
But I don't want you to lose any sleep.
Oh, they do a biopsy on that thing?
Just to make sure.
Okay.
Just to make sure.
I'm looking forward to the healing process, and I'm just a happy camper. Oh my God, look at that thing. Wow. Thank you, Dr. Lee. It was an amazing experience for me, and thank you for the way you responded to me and for your knowledge and your skill.
Okay, I'll see you in a little bit, okay?
All right, baby.
Okay, my girls will get you all set up.
All right.
I don't want to see any missing lipoma. I don't take it home with you. We keep it here.